Absolution by Muse. Arguably Muse's best album yet. A capsule containing Muse's most creative and experimental ventures, the album was a balance the band found after the first two albums, Showbiz and Origin of Symmetry. The former were songs the band had come up with before they broke the global scene, while the latter they made after watching Red Hot Chili Peppers and Foo Fighters live, for whom they were opening in the first American tour. The group felt they didn't have the same rock riffs and heavy elements of the band they had just watched had. The band ended up being very heavy on the second album as a result. This third album, Absolution, is the first time Muse felt they had managed to integrate the two essential aspects of album making, namely the reclusive creative approach and the equipping of the record with potential to perform it live. Muse also widened their approach thematically, where Matt the vocalist plays the agonized protagonist in dystopian songs like Apocalypse Please. The protagonist, a fanatic Christian here, is calling for the world to come to its literal end with the second coming of Jesus. He wants this not only as he's frustrated with the sinful world around him and is yearning for a Christian quasi-utopian world instead, but also because the manifestation of such an event would mean the validation of his own beliefs, and hence a grotesque source of reassurance. Time is running out is another illustration of the dark leitmotif used throughout the record, where the character is nearing the end of his life and the song is an account of his own thoughts pertaining to his end, like the notion of lack of time, regrets and vengeance. And you have Butterflies and Hurricanes. That was written in the memory of Dom, the drummer's father, who passed away right after Muse finished playing live at the Glastonbury Festival. The song captures Dom's fight to regroup and restore purpose. The song's name is inspired by the butterfly effect, which describes the delicate state of the Earth's climate, to where the flapping of a butterfly's wings could unleash a series of chain reactions that ultimately caused a massive hurricane in a different region. The band, unlike the previous two albums, weren't restricted creatively and in terms of time, as they had just signed to the new record label Warner Bros. This gave the group room to experiment extensively with orchestral arrangements, which would go on to be a defining character in all their future work. Additionally, the artwork, which has a man witnessing an apparent rapture, is an allusion to the satirical tone the band sets on the credulity of wishful religious groups, a main target of the deriding theme on the album. Absolution, although as far as it can be from popular music, went on to reach number one on the UK albums chart, with Time Is Running Out peaking at number 8 on the singles charts. The album would go on to be voted the second best album of the 21st century by Kerrang. And as intended by the band, the album produced some of their best live songs, which helped them earn awards for Best British Live Act twice.